All right, guys, it is a beautiful Saturday, and I am back out here on the recycled concrete road and pad project that I initially put in back in, I think, November, and then I widened it up about a month later. Came in here, we put in some more. So yesterday I came in, I got rained out on Thursday, and the dump truck needed some TLC, some maintenance work. So yesterday I came in here and dropped 35 tons of this recycled concrete, and the plan here is today, after I did this brush cutting through here, we're gonna take these five loads and extend it as far down this path that I cut earlier this week as we can go. Now, the client is aware that this full five loads, this 35 tons is not gonna get us, all the way back to the tree stand. So we're kind of doing this in parts as he gets the money. So I don't know how far this 5 tons is going to take us, but it's just enough to cover this little route here, enough to get a four-wheeler through here or be able to walk on. So it doesn't have to be anything super thick. It's not going to be really driven on anything by anything heavy. So I got the skid steer warming up, and we'll get to it. And then one other thing, when I initially put this this road and pad in here, I had a bunch of comments saying this thing was going to sink into the mud and it was just not going to work and yada yada yada. And you can see, I think, what, Thursday we got like 6 inches of rain, and then Friday I was in here driving on this with the dump truck with, you know, 7 tons of you know, rock in the back, no issue, you know. So this pad is solid as a rock in here. This recycled concrete isn't great for a lot, especially this particular stuff, but what it is good for is putting in like these construction entrances and stuff like this. So let's hop in the skid steer and get this thing started. found a big piece of rebar like that yesterday when I was dumping this stuff. Gotta be on the lookout for that. That can mess up your undercarriage real quick. Need a new air filter after all this dust. Thank you.
back and give me a prick in my neck. Thank you.
right, guys, job's done. I don't want to call it, I got it graded in, because this stuff is so chunky, it's almost impossible to grade, but kind of used a little bit to fill in that little hole right there. Wasn't quite enough, but it'll work for now. But the main, I didn't want to use too much out here. The main priority was this trail. So I'll show you how far we got. I'm going to say it's probably about a third of the way. So we got down to this bend. Let's see. I kind of had to use a little bit more rock than I intended to reinforce this corner, because when I was coming back and backed up in here to make that turn, the ground is a little soft here, and it just kind of made a disaster here a little bit. So I just kind of reinforced this corner with a little bit of extra rock, and then we got down to right about there. It's about halfway. This is about almost to the end of this little path that I cut through here. This was the first cut, and then it came out into this pre-existing road that was already here, or trail that was already here. So, and then that's where I started the second cut going around that bend. So maybe another 35 tons would do it. Maybe. Might be closer to like 42 to 50, I think, but 35 would get close. Need a little bit more in here, but for the most part, the way he wants it, he wants to be able to walk through here on this concrete and not have to worry about snakes. So that's what he wants. So I don't ask questions, I just do what people tell me to do. So, but all in all, I think it turned out pretty well. Not too bad. I mean, you're not gonna be driving on this with a truck, but it'll definitely support a four-wheeler to help these trails not get too muddy and rutted up. So that'll work. It's not really the best stuff to walk on. It's a little rocky, but I think it'll lay down pretty good. But all in all, yeah, I think we need one more load out here to kind of level. You can't really see it, but it kind of tapers off that way a little bit more than what I'd like. One more load in here to kind of dress up this edge would do nice, but this guy's not looking for anything pretty. It's just to sit a container out here and come out here when he wants to and hunt and ride a four-wheeler. So all right, well, it's a beautiful Saturday. I'm gonna load the skid steer up and I try to go fishing this afternoon. I don't know. So I didn't really have any other choice with the GoPro but to put you guys in the cab with me with that thing. And we're doing these trails, so I had a comment saying, you know, someone really liked the end cab, but so I've been sticking this little, I have this little sticky thing that I can stick to the door on there, so I think it works pretty well. No more head cam. I'm done with the head cam. I learned my lesson on the head cam. So, but I just kind of stick it right here to the door and just kind of angle it down at the bucket or the cutter or whatever, and it works pretty well. So I hope you guys are liking that, and I'll do some other angles and stuff, you know, obviously some outside the cab on some other jobs, but it just didn't really work on this. So, but I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you guys are having a great weekend. Stay safe out there, and I will catch you on the next one.